Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Coffee with Coach. Today we have come with a new video of TCS NQT Mock Advanced Aptitude Solution. In this video we have solved all the advanced aptitude problems. Previously we have also solved the mock test entirely, how to do, and also some of the other parts like standard aptitude problem has been solved by us. We have also solved the English and the coding section. So if you have not seen any of this video, do watch this video, because in all the videos we have explained it in details. So with this, let us move on to our section of advanced aptitude. Please watch this video till end, as we have solved all the advanced aptitude problems for you. So let us move on to our first question. The first question is, function f satisfy f0 equal to 0, f2n equal to fn, and f2n plus 1 equal to fn plus 1 for all positive integers n. What is the value of f2018? Please do not add white space around the answer. Now, first, let me tell you some basic things before starting off. All the options that you will be seeing over here in select option, whatever the option is given in the mock test, are incorrect. They have just given it for your convenience to show you that the options will be there. So do not panic. I got many replies from your side that these answers are wrong, these options are wrong, but this is just the dummy options. So do not panic about it. So I'll move on further with my question. So the question is, f satisfy f0 equal to 0. So one important tip, whenever you get this kind of problem, try to resolve them in factors and then calculate the value of them from it. So let me show you how to do it. First, what is the value? So let me write the equation. Fn means over here 2018, f2018 equal to, now here you can see it's in 2n, f2n equal to fn. So can I put this in 2n form? f2018 divided by 2, we will get 1009. So I can write it as 2 into 1009. Okay, so this is 2n, so which is equal to fn, so equal to f1009. So now we can see 1009. Can you divide entirely by 2? No. So it will have a remainder. So here we will use this one. So one thing to note, whenever there is an even number, f2n equal to fn, and whenever we have an odd number, we will use this equation, f2n plus 1 equal to fn plus 1. Now here we will use this one, f2n plus 1 equal to, so we can get this, so we can write 1f1009 as we can write as f504 into 2 plus 1 equal to, so this is my 2n, so this is my n, I can write it as f504 plus 1. So you can understand, though this equation looks difficult to solve, but it is quite easy. So now this is an even number, so this is my fn. Now so now what I have to do is, okay, let me divide this, because this will be a very big one. So f504, now let me do with f504. Now f504 is again an even number. When we have an even number, we can write it as f504 equal to 252 into 2. So I can just write 252 here. So again, f252 is an even number. So again, I can write this as here, if I write f252 equal to, again, I can make it 252. What is a half of 252? 126. Now f126 equal to, as it is an even number, f63. Now we again got a odd number. Now this you have to deduce in this way, this form, f2n plus 1. So I can write f63 equal to, 63 equal to f31 fn plus 1. I hope you are understanding, because 63 I can write as 31 into 2 plus 1. So my n becomes 31. So f31 plus 1. So again, 31 is an odd number. f31 equal to, I can write f15 plus 1, as it is an odd number. Now 15 is also an odd number. So f15 equal to, I can write f7 plus 1. 7 to the 14 plus 1 15, so here f7. Similarly f7 equal to f3 plus 1. Now f3 equal to f2 plus 1. Now you can see it's just like a chain thing, it's going on. Now f2 equal to, as it is an even number, I can write f2 equal to f1. Now what is the last value that we can have? F0 is given. Now f1 equal to, as it is an odd number, f0 plus 1, and I have the value of 0. Now you have to back calculate. What you have to do, just calculate how many 1s we got till f2 0 1 8. Now 1 plus 1 2, 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 1 4, 4 plus 1 5, 5 plus 1 6, and this 7. So I got f2 0 1 8 equal to 7. Therefore F2018 equal to 7. So this is my answer. I hope you have understood the question and answer. If not, please do comment us. We love to hear comments from you. With this, we'll move on to the next question. So the second question is, a chord of circle has length 3n, where n is a positive integer. The segment cut off by the chord has height n as shown. What is the smallest value of n for which radius of the circle is also a positive integer? Please do not add white space around the answer. As I have already mentioned in my previous video, that in this kind of question you can click on this diagram, it will pop out. To solve this question, so what it has told, a chord of circle has length 3n. So this is a chord of the circle. So what is a chord, guys? A chord is a line drawn from the two point of a circle. It does not have to be in the middle. So let me just, my diagram skills are not very good, so bear with me. Okay, think it to be a straight line, though it is not looking like a straight line. So let me consider this point as to be the center of the circle. Okay, so from center, if I draw any line, first from center if I draw any line, this will be my radius. If I just extend this line, so total is r, because if I have taken radius as r, this is total is r. So if this, the entire thing is n, so this, can I write it as r minus n? This entire thing is 3n. So can I write this to be 3n by 2? And this to be 3n by 2. So now, if it's a straight line, the angle it will make is always a 90 degree. Now let me take a straight line. Okay, I have just joined this line, if you see. Now let me consider this as to be A, this to be B, O is my center, and this is my C. Okay, so from here, as you can see, I have drawn a line AO. This is 90 degree, this is also a 90 degree. So I can use a Pythagoras theorem. So from here I can write OA square equal to AC square plus OC square, which is equal to, like, r square. OA square is an r square, equal to r minus n whole square, r minus n whole square plus 3 by 2 n square, 3 by 2 square whole square. Now let me show you in the diagram. OA means this one, from a point center to any point is always the radius, so r square. As I told you before, if this is n and the entire thing is r, then I can take this one to be r minus n. So this is r minus n, and this is 3 by 2 n square. I know my diagram is a little bit messy, but I hope you are understanding. So from here I can just deduce as r square equal to r minus n whole square, that I can write as r square plus n square minus 2nr plus 3 square is 9. Now 2 square is 4, and this is n square. If I solve this, r square will cancel, and this will come to as, because of space, I'm just solving it directly. This is 2r equal to 13 by 4n. You can see there's a relationship between r and n. So directly I can write r equal to 13 by 8n. n. Now what it has said is the smallest value of n for which the radius is always a positive integer. We have to take one one number and we have to check when it will become a integer, guys. Very easy. You can see from here 8 is there in the denominator. So n minimum value is 8. Then only it will cancel it out. So minimum value is 8. So the answer, what is the smallest value of n? The smallest value is 8. So I hope you have understood this question. If any doubt, please do ping us in the comment and let us know. So moving on to the question number 3. Now the question number 3 is, if n is a positive integer, let Sn denote the integer obtained by removing the last digit of n and placing it in front. For example, S731 equal to 173. What is the smallest positive integer n ending in 6 satisfying Sn equal to 4n? Please do not add white space around the answer. Okay. So after reading this question, one thing you can understand from here, whenever this S is 731, so if a number is 731, then S731 will be equal to 173. That means the last digit will be shifted in the first, and whatever the digit is, whether it's 731 or whether it's 73331, only the first digit will be shifted in front, and whatever it is, the remaining will come here. For example, if 731, it comes 173. If this is the number, then it will be 17 and then followed with 3 threes. So this is the logic that you have to understand in this question. Now to solve this equation, what you have to do, first let us take, let n equal to 10a plus 6, where a has k digit. Now you must be wondering from where I have brought this equation. Very easy, guys. This is a simple deduction of this one. If a number is there, for example 173, to get a 173, how I can write? If 10a means 10 into 17 plus 3, if I write, it will of course come to 173. So this is what I have deduced, and form a general equation from any number. It may be a 4-digit number, it may be a 5-digit number. It does not matter. This is an equation. You must have done this in your programming also. Now let n equal to 10a plus 6, where a has k digit. So of course n will always have k plus 1 digit, because see, let us take the example of 173. When a has 2 digit, then n will be a 3 digit number. When a will be a 2 digit number, of course n will be a 3 digit number, because we are multiplying it with 10. Now we got this one. This is the n. To get Sn, what you have to do, Sn will always be, so if we, in this question, if there is a number ending in 6 satisfying Sn equal to 4n, if we shift 6 out there, then it will be of course be 6 into 10 to the power k plus a. Let us take an example, then you may be understanding it properly, because a number is ending with 6. For example, the number is 2556. Okay, so I can write this number according to this equation, 10 into 255 plus 6. So if we do, you can see here we got this number. Now Sn will be equal to 6255. So now let us put this over here. If you see, 6 into 10 to the power, sorry, this will be k, 10 to the power k over here, the number of a. So what was my a over here? This is 3. So 10 to the power 3 plus a. So a is 255. So if this is 10 to the power 3, so it will be 6000 plus 255. So if you see here, I got 6255. So I hope with this example you have understood the logic. This is equal, this is what I want, this is the logic of the question. So I hope you can understand why I deduce in this way. So from this, as there is an equation Sn equal to 4n, what is my Sn? This is my Sn. So Sn is 6 into 10 to the power k plus a equal to 4n. So 4 into what is my n? 10a plus 6. Now you solve this equation. After solving the equation, we'll get 6 into 10 to the power k equal to 40a plus 24. After deducing, I can directly write as 2 into 10 to the power k minus 8, 13a. Now we have to use a trial and error method over here. We need to check for what value of k, 2 into 10 to the power k minus 8 is directly divisible by 13. So guys, do not panic over here thinking that it will take a lot of time. You have a calculator on the top of the screen. So this is a right time you can utilize. Let me take the values of k. Let me take first 1. So when I have taken k as 1, so it will be 2 into 10 to the power 1, that is 20. 20 minus 8 equal to 13a. So what is this value? This is 12. 12 equal to 13a. So as I told you before, you have to search a multiple of 13. So of course 12 is not a multiple, so k equal to 1 you cannot take. So now let us take k equal to 2 here. Now when we are taking the value of k equal to 2, so it will be 200 minus 8, so that will be equal to 200 minus 8 is 192. 192 is also not a multiple of 13. The calculator will be mentioned, so you can use the calculator. Now when k equal to 3, still it won't be a divisible by 13. Now you check from k 4, still it won't. K, when you take k equal to 5, it will come to 1 1 2 3 4, 5 times 9 and then 2, because when you are taking 3, it will be like 1992. So in this way, it will be 4 times, this will be 4 times 9, 2. If you divide by 13, it will come to 15384. Now you have to put as what it have said here, what is the smallest positive integer n. N you have to search, you have already got the value of a. Just put it in the equation, n is equal to 15384 into 10 plus 6, which will be equal to 153846. So this is the answer. Do not think, as I told you, to use trial and error method. It will be a long sums. You have a calculator, so you can utilize the calculator and solve it fast. So with this, I am moving on to the next question. But before that, we have a website. The link is given in the description. Please do visit the website of ours. There will be so many materials we'll be soon uploading. It will be very helpful if you are sitting for the placement drive. We will be also upload different kind of interview experiences and what you need to know about the companies. The website link is in the description. If you are liking what I am teaching it to you, please do not forget a thumbs up. Share it with your friends and do subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon. With this, let us move on to the next question. So the fourth question is, of all the non-empty subset S of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, how many do not contain the number S, where S denotes the number of element in S? For example, 3, 4 is one such subset since it does not contain the number 2. If you have not understand the question, let me explain you. For example, if I take a 2 element subset like 1 and 3, so this is valid as the number 2 is not there. So when it will be a 2 element subset, number 2 cannot be there. When it is a 3 element subset like 1, 5, 7, 3 should not be here. So this is what the rule in this question. So let us set with 1 element. So how many numbers we can, if we are taking 1 element subset, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total number is 6. The combination is like 6C1. So how to search? I hope you know how to search a combination, but just let me show you for one. Next you can do it yourself. Just as a revision, I'm showing you how to solve a combination problem. So 6 factorial by 1 factorial by 6 minus 1 factorial. So equal to 6 factorial by 1 factorial into 6 minus 1, that is 5 factorial. From here I can easily get it is 6. So by this, if you do not know the formula and the concept of combination, then do watch our video of the combination. We have already made a video on combination in aptitude section. Go to our playlist and check the video. So moving on to the next, if we are taking a like two element subset, then 6C2, because total number is 6, combination is 2. Similarly, 6C3, 6C4, 6C5 and 6C6. So 6C2 equal to 15. I have solved. If you cannot, then please do go and watch our previous video. Here I am solving it directly. This is 6C3 is 20, 6C4 is 15, 6C5 is 6, 6C6 is 1. Now one more thing you must be thinking, why I haven't taken a subset of 7 element? Because if I take a subset of 7 element, then I have to include the number 7 also. But according to the question, I cannot use the number of element which I am taking. So 7 I have excluded. So here what you have to do, you just have to add all the elements like 6C1 plus 6C2 plus dot 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 till 6C6. So if I add all, 6 plus 15 plus 20 plus 15 plus 6 plus 1, that comes to 63. So 63 is my answer over here. I hope this question was quite easy. Just you need a basic understanding of the combination. Go and watch our video of combination. With this, let me move on to the next question, the last question of ours, question number 5. So the last question is, how many pairs of mn of integers satisfy the equation 4 to the power m equal to n square plus 15? So how to solve this kind of problem? First, let me write 4m equal to n square plus 15. 4 to the power m I can write as 2 square m. I have written 4 as 2 square. Equal to n square plus 15. Now this one I can write as 2m whole square minus n square equal to 15. I can easily use the a square minus b square formula. So 2 to the power m plus n and 2 to the power m minus n, a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b equal to 15. Now you have to check what are the values possible. So let me take out a factor of 15. I can write 15. I can write as 1 into 15. This is one possible. I can write 15 into 1, 3 into 5, and I can also write 5 into 3. Let me take this one. If I take this one, then 2 to the power m plus n equal to 1 and 2 to the power m minus n equal to 15. So this is one value possible. Another value is 2 to the power n m plus n equal to 15, and here I can write 2 to the power m minus n equal to 1. Similarly, you can do for this. How to calculate this? This is a simple quadratic equation you can solve. From here I can get m equal to 3, n equal to 7. Similarly, you will get values for all the values of the factors. So how many here, what it has asked, how many pair of mn of integers satisfy? So here it comes as 4. So 4 is my answer. As you can see, number of factors that are coming is 4. This is a simple trick that you can go. So I hope you have understood what I have taught you. If not, please do not forget to comment us, and do not forget to join us in our WhatsApp group. You can join us in WhatsApp by following the form in the description. Do fill the form and join us in WhatsApp. With this, let me end my video here. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you have liked the video, please give us a thumbs up. Do subscribe our channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon. With this, all the best. Bye-bye.